Okay, everybody, we are going to do a very, very quick one. I say this a lot, but this really is going to be quick. So I've started my game up. We're back to having this button on the tree. If you haven't seen the previous tutorial where we talk about interacting with a button, this time we're going to talk about putting in delay, making something happen when we interact with a button. So I'm going to interact with a button right now. And we're going to wait 3 seconds, and then down in the bottom, you can see my shield shows up so that I have some shield in my inventory. So that 3 second delay is what we're concentrating on today. So we're going to learn how to use the sleep function. Okay, so I've opened up UEFN and we need to get to our logic, our verse code, and it's in the game manager. So inside of all my application, my project, creative devices, I have game manager, I'm going to double click that. That's going to open up my verse file that I use for my game manager. I've stuck everything in here, which isn't the very best idea. I'll talk about more. I've already talked about a little bit, but a little bit more about how to sort out your code. But what we want to look at is what happens when the button is clicked. And we've talked about this in the past tutorial, as I said. I'll link to that in the description below. But we've got our shield button, which is the one on the tree, and it calls on button click. So let's start with that. We go down into on button click, and the click of the button, or the event interaction event, sends the agent to the function that you define, on button click in this case. So we've got agent, and what we're going to do is we're going to use spawn, and we're going to call another function. Now, inside of there is this sleep function. So the point is that we want to delay making something happen. But when you make when you use sleep, essentially what you're doing is there's going to be a thread that runs. So your application does a bunch of stuff, you know, whatever it is, it fires off events, it makes things happen, it gifts things to people, it whatever. And if you want to put in sleep, if you want to say, I want you to go to sleep and then do a thing, then essentially you'd be telling your main runner to stop doing anything, because sleep puts everything to sleep. So what we have to do is we have to call spawn. When we call spawn, it means that we are going to bring another runner into existence, and that runner is going to be like, okay, what have I got to do? You have to sleep for 3 seconds before you go do a bunch of other stuff, so that the main runner can continue doing the running. I don't know if that makes any sense. That's the analogy that I like when I was looking it over. I thought, you know, this just seems like you were doing a relay run or something, but everybody has to run. If you needed something to happen, say, well, I just needed to put a pause and then do a thing in a little bit. So that do the thing in a little bit is sleep. And then we can do all of our stuff of giving the shield potion, setting up the shield and the health, and making our vulnerability false, which makes us invincible. So the key to putting a delay into thing is doing spawn, and then calling the sleep function to put things to sleep for 3.0 seconds. This is a float, so you can do 3.1, whatever. Any, you can do 0.1, you can do 0, but it has to be a float. And the only other thing that we need to do is add in the suspends sort of modifier to the function, because essentially we are suspending our runner in time, saying, okay, we're going to spawn a new runner, a new thread, and that thread needs to do a thing, but we're going to suspend it. And we wouldn't need this suspends in here if we weren't going to call sleep. So that is the last key in this whole thing. You have to define that the function is going to suspend a thread, or stop a runner, pause a runner from running along doing its thing. So hopefully that helps make some sense. If not, ask any question you want down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.